Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the kitchen. Now, conditions just perfect for making tea. Hopefully now we'll see some excellency on display this evening. Just holding out now for the two sides to emerge. Interesting to see how his experience will show if he can bounce back after what can only be described as a heavy weekend. Max now looking thirsty and ready for it. Searching around the kitchen for the suitable apparatus now. A long searching ball out for a cup. I didn't mean to say ball, but okay. Searching hand out for a cup. And no luck, he's going to have to try a simpler route, and he's found one in the dishwasher. Thank Christ for that now. Is the material in the dishwasher ready? No, apparently not. We're going to have that wash now. It's a clean wash. Getting the hand in. No brush. Going to go with the hand. Hopefully his hands are clean. We're going to have to hope for that. Looks suitably rinsed now. Of course, the boiling water will suitably sterilize the water before the tea goes in. Now, drying, of course, using kitchen paper rather than a tea towel. Not exactly hygienic, but again, have to remind the viewers at home that we are going to sterilize it with the boiling water that, of course, the tea will be made mainly of. Searching around now for... Well, the obvious next component now is just to use all his experience getting the kettle ready. He's going to open up the tea bag. Sensible move. He goes for the snapshot and unlucky there. It was a good effort by Max. He's going to take it from close range. He's going to bring it in now. He's taking his time with this, showing all his experience in making tea with just not rushing it. And what method will we go with here? He's going straight into the nozzle rather than opening the lid. Interesting, but classic Max now. This has been him all over since day one. All the way in. Only enough for one. Selfish? Maybe. But a player of his quality, that's what you expect. Moving things out of his way so subtly, so casual, stroking everything around beautifully. He knows what he's doing. Going for the low-fat milk there. His coach will be happy to see that. I'm afraid to root around the cutlery drawer, is that? He's going for the biscuits now. Very early on. Or are they the tea bags? My mistake, it's the tea bags already, without the tea even boiled. We're waiting for that click from the kettle up before... Oh, he's lost control! Well recovered. Aggressively ripping into the open biscuits. Is he taking the whole packet? Well, why not? Crunching up the paper like it's nobody's business and straight into the bin. First shot, first time, goal. Beautiful effort. Now, getting stuck into a biscuit before the tea? Classic Max. All the way in. Squeeze it. Push it. No. Oh, it's there. The biscuits are in now, and that's stage one complete of the process. But now, it's all about keeping concentration at this stage. At this high level, waiting for that kettle to click can be the most difficult period of the entire tea-making game. Maybe another biscuit, separate into two piles and take for the very bottom biscuit. But has the cat been walking on the countertop? Who knows? Who knows? And we're just waiting for something to happen here. It really feels like the tension is boiling over. You could cut it with a knife. We've all been waiting for this for so long, and very often with these big occasions, it's almost a bit of an anticlimax, but of course, you can just feel that in any given moment, this can boil over into something remarkable. Casually stroking it around again, as I've said before, showing all his experience. It's incredible to watch, really, at this high level. When you compare it to the lower levels, some people burning their hands, dropping the biscuits. He's even taking out a newspaper. This man knows how to enjoy a good tea. He's always ready. You can always feel that. All he really needs is that one little click, and everything will be okay. So casual, but it's really, you can sense he knows what he's doing. You can tell he's been well coached, well trained. You can only wonder how much tea this man has made. Countless, hundreds, thousands, maybe even millions. Now, I'm not sure if I agree with this. Now, that is his third biscuit since the kettle went on. Now, of course, the kettle, this day and age, could take any time. Oh, what's this? We have an intruder now. He's marking it very well. He's been well marshalled by Paddy. He's really harrying him there, not afraid to tug the shirt. But he won't go down. Of course, something so synonymous with today's game. No simulation here. There's the click. That's what we've been waiting for. He's pouring it straight in. Has the teabag already gone in? The teabag's already in. I'm just being told that the teabag is already in. And now with the water in, the process is nearly complete. Milk at the ready. Biscuits at the ready. Little staring match between Paddy and Max there. You can really sense the history between these two. They were so close before in the living room, and now since they've moved to the kitchen, things have just changed. Little bit argy-bargy there. Only handbags, really. Nothing was ever likely to boil over, but you have to respect both players for not making the most of it, both standing up and keeping things moving. Max presses the spoons firmly against the side of the cup. One can only imagine the pressure the teabag is under beneath the side of the cup and the spoon. First shot, first time it's in the bin. Now it's time for the low-fat milk now. All the way in, little rise, little dip, rise and dip again, and it's all in. Not a single drop spilled. Put that thing back in the fridge, Max. Go on, I'll open the fridge. Oh, yeah, there you go. Keep it cold. Ready for the next user. Has there been a spillage we missed? It looks like there may have been. And we... Sorry, the camera missed it. We're going to have to look back at that one now. Just have a... You can see here, Max spills a little bit. It was missed by the cameras originally, but there was a clear ring of tea, is it? It's tea. There's a ring of tea now. Of course, he looks after it first time, as any young man would. Brilliantly dealt with. So one... clean swoop. Absorb the extra moisture from the side of the cup before cleaning the ring you've already left. One last little shove on Paddy to let him know he's there. He's going to want to take up some of that territory soon. He's entering into the area now. Dancing around the area, just waiting for a little gap. But he's standing off. He's not giving him any space. But he uses his physicality there, much like Didier Drogba of old, using his physicality to get the competition out of the game. And a dunk. Beautiful entry. Straight in. Again, no drip. Starting on the sports pages of the paper. We like that here. And now, really, you can see the look on Paddy's face. He's a beaten man. Casually licking his wounds. And he peters off into obscurity. Embarrassing. You can really see the pride in Max's face as he reads over the paper. The cat who got the mouse, if you will. Excellent work by the youngster there. Really showed all his experience and what can only be described as what was a tense affair. And now, casually enjoying the tea. Really working on that biscuit there. Not afraid to take an extra few bites between dunks. Let that one absorb for a while. You want to be careful it doesn't break and sink to the bottom of the cup. Because really... there is nothing worse, especially as it seems he's already gotten rid of the spoon. He might have difficulty fishing. No, the spoon is there. He'd have no difficulty fishing that out, should that be the case. But unfortunately, isn't a word. All the way in. Another biscuit from Max now. Anyone keeping track of the biscuits would be well advised to text in now. If you could just send a text to 087-9323-870, that's 087-9323-870, if you're keeping an eye on the biscuits. Now, we know the prize here today, 2 tickets to Andy making coffee in the attic. That's right, it's a special prize, doesn't happen very often. But if you could just keep right now, the question is, how many biscuits did Max have during the process? Now, of course, there is still a pile there to be had, but up until this point, is it A, 9, B, 32, or C, D? Well, patience was the order of the day at the kitchen, and in the end, quality of possession shone through as Max is sitting, sipping on a nice, boiling hot cup of tea. You can really sense the kitchen beginning to feel like a fortress today, but at the end of the day, it's the bookmakers that go home happy. And now back to the boys in the studio for further analysis. I've been Neil Smith, thank you, and good evening.